Hello everyone, good morning. First of all, warm welcome to OIC training by UnoGeeks. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use a JavaScript function or a JavaScript library in OIC. Okay, so if I show you, let's log into OIC instance and let's go to integration work area. Let's go to integration designer work area. And if you go to integration designer work area, you see a libraries option, right? So if you click on libraries, this is where you can register. This is where you can register a JavaScript function or a JavaScript library. Okay, you can register your JavaScript library or function here first. And then once you register that JavaScript library, you can go ahead and use it in any of the integration flows that you're going to build later on. Okay, so we'll see. In this video, I'll show you how to register a JavaScript library and how to use it in the integration flows. Okay, we'll pick up a simple use case. So the use case is to build a REST API, which will receive two numbers as input, number one and number two. And we will also receive an operation as input. So that operation could be addition or subtraction, or probably what we do is we receive two numbers as input, and we will sum them up using a JavaScript function. Okay, so we're going to register a JavaScript library with an add function, and we're going to invoke that function within this API. And when you invoke that JavaScript function, it expects you to pass in two parameters. That's how we're going to define the JavaScript function. And we pass in the two numbers that we are going to receive as input to that JavaScript function. So that JavaScript function will add those numbers up and it returns a sum. It returns the sum value and we will return that back to the client. A pretty simple use case, but our intention is to show you the process of registering a JavaScript library and invoking it within the integration flows. You can extrapolate it and use it in other real-time scenarios. Okay, let's go ahead and start the integration then. Let's create a connection first. We need a trigger connection. And since it's a REST API, I'll use a REST adapter. UnoGeeks. JavaScript REST trigger connection. And change the role to trigger. Change the security policy to basic authentication. Save it. Test the connection again. Save it. And let's go ahead and create an integration now. Use app-driven orchestration style. UnoGeeks. Use a JavaScript library. Well, let's take out use a JavaScript library REST API. It's okay. And put it in UnoGeeks package and create it. And let's first configure the trigger connection in this API. Change the layout to horizontal. Use the UnoGeeks trigger connection that we have created just now, a JavaScript trigger connection. And we will receive numbers to sum. Click on next. And we will, what will this operation does? It will receive or two numbers as input, sums them up, and send it back as a response. Pretty simple web service or API. So configure two template parameters, number one and number two. action is get. And configure this endpoint to receive response as well, because we need to get back a result. Click on next. You should see two numbers getting created. That's fine. Number one and number two as template parameters, and configure the response. Change it to JSON sample. And let's call it result, and let's assign a number, maybe two or three, any sample number. Click OK. And click on done. And what do I want to do? I'm receiving two numbers as input here. I want to sum them up. To sum them up, there are already a lot of predefined functions available in OIC. Don't think that we need to register a JavaScript library even to add two numbers. That's not the right understanding. We have picked up a simple JavaScript library which will add in two numbers, as simple as that. Okay, don't think that even that simple functionality is not available in OIC. And first thing we need to do is, before we could invoke a JavaScript library, we need to go ahead and register the JavaScript function first in the libraries tab. So go back, go to libraries tab, and let's create a JavaScript library. And the JavaScript library, or a JavaScript function that we are going to add in, is this. It's a pretty simple function. Yeah, it's a simple JavaScript function which takes in two numbers as input, parameter one and parameter two, and it will add them up. We're doing a summation there, and the result gets assigned to a variable, and we are returning that variable. Remember, for a JavaScript function or for a JavaScript library to be registered in OIC, it needs to have an explicit return value. So you cannot just say, so you need to define a variable and then return that variable. You cannot just say a return parameter one plus parameter two here directly. So it needs to have an explicit return variable. Please bear that in mind. So I want to register this JavaScript function here. So I'll call it as geeks add a JavaScript library, or I'll say function. Okay, and let's browse and let's add in this file, this JavaScript file. Select the JavaScript file and click on create. And you can also probably add in a description if you want. And it will show you the functions that are available within the JavaScript file. You could have multiple functions. Typically, we just had one, but if required, you can add in multiple functions as well. Okay. And yes, you have added that function. Save it. So you see two parameters will be taken as input. You can probably change them to number. Two numbers will be taken as input, and a number will be returned as an output. Save it. Go back. And we have registered the library now. We have registered add a JavaScript function, and we want to invoke this from the integration flow. So let's go back to the API that we were building earlier. Edit the API. And I want to invoke the JavaScript function in this API. Okay, I want to invoke the JavaScript library here. So you click on the plus icon and just type in a JavaScript, start typing in Java. You see a function available there. You can call it invoke add JavaScript function. Create. And you can click on the plus icon, and that will show you the functions that are available. So select the function that you have registered, geeks add JavaScript function. Select it, and you will be able to see a data type assigned. Okay, so you can also assign the values to this. So you're trying to call the function, JavaScript function now, and you need to assign values here. And what do we need to pass in? What values do we need to pass in? the numbers that we are receiving as input into this API, we need to map them to parameter one and parameter two. So we'll receive number one and number two as input for this API. We will pass them as input to this add function as parameter one and parameter two. So go to parameter one, assign a value, and assign number one. Validate and close. Parameter two, assign number two. So we are just passing the URI parameter or template parameter as input to the JavaScript function. Validate and close. And we want to assign the result back and send it in the response. So go to response wrapper. And there is a result attribute, and you are invoking this JavaScript function, right? So that will give you a return value. So that return value, you can map it to the result attribute, and you can send it back as response to the client. Validate. And close. And you can enable tracking and activate this API, and we can also probably test it. Add number one and number two as attributes, as tracking attributes, save and close. Then go ahead and activate the API. And after you turn it on, we can probably send in a couple of numbers and see if the API is working as expected or not. Test it. And send in two numbers, send the first number as two and the second number as three. And you could also see the values getting passed as template parameters and test the API. So this API is invoking the JavaScript function or library internally, and it gets a response from the JavaScript function, from this JavaScript function to be precise. And that response of five has been sent back as a result to the client. Okay, so this is how you can register a JavaScript library and use it within the integration flows. So we have picked up a simpler function, simpler JavaScript function, but in real time, the function that you might use might be a bit more complex, but the process of registering the JavaScript library and using it within the integration flows doesn't change. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video, guys. In case you are interested in Oracle Integration Cloud training offered by UnoGeeks, please call us on this number or send a WhatsApp message. Or you can also probably send us an email on info@unogeeks.com. And feel free to visit our website to check the Oracle Integration Cloud course content. Thank you.